Can you train Stable Diffusion AI so well that you can generate photos and then post them on your Instagram? In today's video, we're gonna find out. Now, before we get started, there are a couple things you're gonna need. One, you're gonna need a Google Pro Colab account. This is about $10 a month, and it's because we're gonna need an A100 GPU that has enough memory to do the training. And the second thing you're gonna need is space on your Google Drive. Now, I had to upgrade, but you're going to need about 20 gigabytes just for the different models that are going to be saved throughout the training. All right, now that we got that out of the way, let's go ahead and dive in and see how to train this model. All right, so before we can train the model, we need to create our data set of images. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to gather about 12 to 20 images of yourself, mainly around your face in all sorts of different lighting and backgrounds and different clothing. You're also going to want to include about 2 to 3 full body shots and about 4 to 5 upper body shots as well. And you can see here in the example that they have a bunch of different angles, lighting, faces, expressions to train the model on. This will give you the best results. The next thing you're going to want to do here is you're going to want to resize these images to make sure that they are all 512 pixels by 512 pixels. And you can do that using a site called burmy.net. As you can see here, I've uploaded all my images and I'm just selecting the portion to crop. You want to make sure your face is in the center and it's not cut off. And then you're just going to save them all as a zip file, unzip them, and you'll have your training images ready to go. All right, so I have the Google Colab notebook pulled up. And as you can see, this is the JoePenna Dream Booth Stable Diffusion notebook. And one thing I want to mention here is that you do need an A100 in order to run this. You can't use the V100 or the T4 as they don't have enough memory to execute this. So the first step here is just to check that we do have an A100 available. And we do have the A100, it has 40 gigabytes, much more than the 24 gigabytes needed to run this. So we'll go ahead to the next step, which is to clone and download the repo. And I already have it installed, as you can see, as it says it already exists. And the next step here would be to build the environment. So I'll go ahead and click play, and we'll see that it will start downloading all of the packages and dependencies for this to work. Now this does take a while, so I'm going to go ahead and do some video editing magic here so that you don't have to sit and watch this. All right, so one thing I do want to mention is that I was getting a crash error, and it was happening on this os.exit line. So what I did is I just commented it out, and then when I clicked play, it ran all the way through. And I know that it says you might get warnings about restarting the runtime and to resume from the cell, but I just thought it was easier just to comment this out. So now for the next step here, we'll go ahead and just make sure we're in the right directory. So if you look at your files and folders here, you can see we have the Dream Booth Stable Diffusion folder, and we just want to make sure that we're inside of that folder. And we're there. And now we'll go ahead and download the 1.5 standard Stable Diffusion model with the improved VAE. Now this will take a while. All right, the next step here is to download the regularization images. Now regularization allows the model to not overtrain based on the images that we're gonna upload here in a second. It's gonna mix these images in so that the model can tell the difference and learn based on our images. And instead of overtraining and finding patterns that aren't necessarily there, it will mix these images in to ensure that the model understands what our face is versus other people. Now, if you're a man, I suggest using the man unsplash. And if you're a woman, I suggest using the women DDIM. So for this, I'm going to choose the man underscore unsplash, and then I'm going to click the play button. And you can see here, it's downloading them and it's done. And now we'll go to the next step, which is to upload our training images. Now you want to upload an even amount of images. And again, as I showed you earlier, you want 2 to 3 of your full body, 3 to 5 of your upper body, and 5 to 12 close-up on your face. So I'll go ahead and click the play button. and then I'll choose my files and I'll upload them. And you can see here that it is uploading them. Now, if you get any errors on this step, you can just drag and drop them into the training images folder. Okay, and as you can see here, we do have all the images here in the training images folder. I'm just going to delete this duplicate that I have of the JPEG here. All right, and last, we're gonna finish the setup here. So for the project name, I'm just going to call this Stable Diffusion Tutorial. The token, I'm just going to use my first and last name. It makes it very easy, and it has to be something unique. You don't want to use a common word or phrase, as then you're not going to be able to generate an image of yourself when we put this into the Stable Diffusion WebUI. And for the class word, I'm going to use man, and this has to match what you chose in this earlier step for the regularization images. If you chose person, then you're going to use person. If you chose woman, you're going to do woman. If you chose man, you're going to do man. And then the max training steps, I'm going to do 5,000. Now this is a little much, but I'd rather have an overtrained model that I can use one from an earlier step than not have enough training and then I'm kind of stuck and I have to redo this whole process over again. I'm going to leave the I am training a person's face checked, and then I'm going to save a model every 200 steps. This allows me to have a model at 1,000 steps, 1,200, 1,400, 1,600, etc. And then with that, I'm just going ahead and click play. And now this will take about an hour. So you do have to kind of keep this window open and make sure you kind of click into it every once in a while so that Google doesn't kick you out. But after this, we'll go ahead and finish it up and download it. And then we'll go on to the WebUI and generate some images. All right, so I have Stable Diffusion WebUI pulled up here. And the first thing I wanna say is that 5,000 steps is way too many. A lot of the models are overfitted or overtrained, and the ones that I'm using are around 600, 900, 1200, 1500 steps, as high as 2000. But even then you start seeing some of the overfitting. So I would reduce the number of steps, save your compute units, and make sure that you have high quality good images. So with that, I'll start off with some basics of the prompting, as prompting is one of the best ways to get really good photos. Now, because the models that I am using are a little bit overtrained, I'm not going to put my token as the first thing in the prompt. They're going to come a little later. And that's because the model is so well trained that I don't want to put that as the first thing in my prompt, because then it'll start displaying artifacts or other noise that will make it not really look like. So we'll start off with the easy one, and we'll start with cinematic close-up photo of Roland the SD person, 4K UHD, brown hair, brown eyes, and we'll hit generate. Now I am on a Mac, so I can only use my CPU, so they do take about 20 to 30 seconds each one. And so far the preliminary results, it does kind of look like me. It is a close-up photo. And let's take a look. So you can see that the eyes aren't really the same color. The teeth could use a little work as well, but not bad. It does sort of resemble me. Let's see what else we can do here. Maybe cinematic close-up photo of Roland BSD person with a forest behind him. Let's change this to 8K. Change this to brown hair, brown eyes, and hit generate. The results look pretty good. You can see there's a forest. Definitely looks like it looks like me. Pull this one up here, and yeah, this one's pretty good. The teeth maybe a little bit too like perfect, but the eyes look good. The hair resemblance, the beard's good. I mean, this could definitely pass off as a photo. Oh, let's see what else we can do. Oh, instead of a forest, let's go with a city street at night. And let's add a bokeh effect. I like the bokeh. And we'll hit generate. And we'll see it's in progress here. Results. First pass. Oh, looks a little better. This one could be a good one too. Let's check it out. Yeah, you can definitely see the mouth here and this eye. But I do like the bokeh. Definitely has that cityscape. The body type and appearance looks well. We could definitely put this in Photoshop and edit it up and probably make this one pass. And you can also do some in painting here as well. But the first thing I want to show you is some of the prompting that you can do. Now I have a Word doc here with some of the negative prompts you can add in. And these are just things that you don't want in the photo. So anything you don't want, you're just going to type into this negative prompt box here. So you can see we have like cropped, ugly, duplicate, mutilated, out of frame. AI is known for adding extra hands, extra fingers, extra eyes. The eyes usually come out not well. So adding these into the negative prompt can help make your image even better. So with this negative prompt now, let's generate the same one and see what happens. Again, the eye, kind of off there. And then the teeth again, I would say almost a little too perfect. But it is truly amazing, like the lighting and the different backgrounds and clothing styles that the AI can generate. Another thing I wanted to show you is a different prompt format. I've had some good results with this one, so I'll go ahead and paste that in here. And I'll leave these all in either GitHub gist or just right in the description below. So we're going to change the token to the one I'm using for this model. And we'll just fix that typo here. And we'll hit generate, and we'll see what we get with this one. Now this one I'm going to say is probably not going to work out well. Mostly because my training images don't have me at this length or this far away from the camera. So usually when that happens, the image is not going to look anything like me. And yeah, you can see that this one, just not even close. So we'll change up. Instead of wide angle, we'll say close up portrait. And we'll hit generate again and see if there's any differences. Again, this one looks like it might be a little too far away. Probably not going to be one of the better images. Yeah, you can see this face is all distorted and deformed. And that's really how important prompting is in generating these images. You can see just changing the prompt, we're not getting nearly as well results. So I'm just going to take out this raw photo and we'll try one more. And this one seems to look a little better. Definitely off the first pass here. And then you can see this eye right here is a little deformed, but this one's pretty good. You could definitely put this to in painting and swap the eyes out, and you could have a good image. Now there's one other thing I want to show you, and it's a site called Civit.ai or CIVIT.ai, and they have a bunch of different models and images that you can use. So you can see a bunch of different models here. Now I tend to lean towards the realistic ones, so let's check out this epic realism one here. And here you can see different images that people have made using this model. So here you can click on the info button and you can see the different prompts that they've used, and the negative prompts, and also the seed number and some other data, so you can try to recreate these. This is a nice one of Keanu Reeves here. This one does not give you the prompt, but you can see there's a whole bunch of different ones, all different styles. Here's a good one of Tom Holland. And again, you can look at these for different ideas for what you want your prompt to be, what you want your negative prompt to be, the CFG scale, the number of sampling steps, the seed, and if they're using a sampler or anything. And basically what these attributes are. So the sampling steps is the amount of steps it's going to take at reducing the noise in the image. Usually the higher the better results, but I like to keep this between about 25 and 40. The CFG scale is how closely it's going to follow the prompt. So the higher, the more strict it's going to be towards the prompt, and the lower, the more creative it's going to be. Usually anywhere between 3.5 and 7 is where you want to be. And then the seed number. If you find a photo that you like or that you would like another attempt at generating, so we can use this one here, we can take this seed number and paste it in. And when we hit generate again, we can change the prompt, hit generate again, and we should get a similar image, but hopefully fix some of the deformities that we saw in the previous one. Again, a nice black and white with the bokeh and a suit. And we'll generate it again, just to give you guys another example. Yep, so this gives the exact same image because we use that exact same seed number. Now, the other thing you can do is add different LoRAs and embeddings to maybe help with the prompting. So I have a couple here that are pretty popular, the Add Detail and the Epic Real Life. You don't want to go full force on these, so on a scale of 0.1 to 1, I like to keep them at like 0.2, 0.3. And when we generate that, we'll see that there'll be some differences here in the face and in the detail of the photo. Now this one looks promising. This one's not bad. I don't like the little like defocusedness on the face here. But other than that, pretty similar. So where can you find these LoRAs and embeddings and other things that you can use in your prompting and in Stable Diffusion? Well, you can also find them on that civit.ai site as well. And I'll link a couple of my favorite ones in the description below. All right, there you have it. In about 2 hours of your time, you can train Stable Diffusion and AI to make images that are pretty dang close to ones that you would see on Instagram. Now, with a few other things like creating an embedding, or even making your own LoRA, you can probably get these models trained well enough that you can make images that are so good that you could post them on Instagram. You know, if you like this content, please consider liking and subscribing. Also, if you have any tips or tricks on how to train the model or make it even better, please feel free to go ahead and drop a comment below. I'd definitely like to see if there's better ways to do this. And with that, I'll see you in the next video. We'll be right back.